Hi friends, today we're going to show you how to recycle foam nets. This is how it looks when it's done. Let's begin. First, you need at least one foam net. Pull one strand off the net. You have to be careful because it's easy to break. One strand can make two petals. Today we're going to make plum blossoms. So each flower has 5 petals. Foam nets are often found wrapped around delicate fruits. They're mostly for protection, like a snug, but it creates environmental issues. Why? Because they are typically made from non-biodegradable materials. It takes a very long time to break down in the environment. They often become pollution. They can end up being landfills or oceans, causing harm to wildlife. So let's try to recycle foam nets today. Try to turn trash into something beautiful. Yay! But to save the world isn't easy. See how difficult Mom pulls the strand. It's okay, keep trying. Don't give up. But you can use scissors and any way you like. Nobody sees it. Keep trying. It's okay. Let's make petals. Break one strand into 2 equal strands. Let's make it into a swirl.
Yes, a swirl is indeed a pattern of twisting or spiraling. It often describes a shape or design characterized by a twisting or circular motion.
Use double-sided tape to hold the petal in place. Make a base of 5 petals. And then add 3 more petals on top. For the core of the flower, we used the golden heart sticker, but you can use whatever you have at hand. Finally, add a double-sided tape to the back of the flower. Stick your flower to a branch, because Mom made so many mistakes on pulling the strand. We end up with 4 flowers. The last one has only 3 petals.
Have you heard of less is more?
Our wax plum blossom is done. It is beautiful, isn't it? Most importantly, we made a contribution to our planet through arts and crafts. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.